No doubt in saying that this era is completely dominated by apps. Every nth second, you can see an app coming out because that is basically a platform that can attract customers to your business. So saying that, with limited resources and high budget app developers, we are in a high time to find an alternative solution for this. And that's why we are here. Hey guys, this is Jack and I welcome you to another episode of App DNA by Zoho Creator. The app that which we're going to create today is Seat Bookings. You might own a Cineplex, or do you host some theater dramas? I guess you will be depending upon the third party sites for seat bookings, but that's not going to be there anymore because you can create an app by yourself. So that is what we're going to see for today in this app tutorial. Okay, when I say this, the next thing you could ask me is how? How am I going to build an app as such? Trust me guys, even I'm not a developer. But I have learned how to build an app with Zoho Creator, and now I build a lot of apps and I also teach you guys. So see how easy is Zoho Creator. Zoho Creator is an online Deluge scripting language where you just have to drag and drop these elements and build your own custom apps. It's very easy and you're going to learn in just less than 30 minutes. In this app, we're going to see three essential features. The first feature is show details, because here is where you can show all your details of your shows that you're gonna host it. The second next feature is book your seat. Here you can allow your customers to come and book their seat and pay you online. The third feature is you have done with the two forms. Don't you have to share this with your customers? So here we're gonna see how to publish this app, and also we'll send some notifications to your customers. I guess you guys are clear with these three essential features of this app. Now we're going to take a look at how to create the first form, show details.
So guys, welcome to Zoho Creator homepage. Here is the place where we're going to create our application. You have two options available. Either you can import a file and create an application, or you can create it from the scratch. So I'm going to use the new application option and create it from scratch. And you also can available these pre-developed apps which are there in this app deck and install this and make use of for your organization. So I'll click create a app from the scratch and name this app as Seat Booking. Now we are into the home page of this Zoho Deluge scripting language. Here you can create a form, do workflows, design this application as ever you want, and then you can share it with your customers or users. So I'm just going to create a new form here. Our first form will be for the show details. Here the logic behind this form is we want to collect the show details and show it to the our customers. So I'm going to click a blank form and name it as show details. Here you can see the workspace where we just have to drag and drop the elements from your left hand side to the right corner so that you can use all the details that you want to collect from the form. So that's it. I'm going to use, as I said, the logic is here to show the details of the particular show that you're going to host. I'm going to take a single line field and name it as show name. Next, I'm going to use another single line field to use for the show theme. Next, I'm going to use a multi-line field to get the show description. Next, I'm going to use a date field to show on which this drama will be hosted on. And if you at all you guys want the timing of this particular show, you can use different field which can show the date and time. So I'll just erase this and add a new field. Next, I want to add an address field to show where is my venue. So next, I'm going to use a number field to get the total number of available seats for the particular drama. Next, I'm going to use a currency field to show the price amount for a particular drama, that is ticket price. So that's it guys, these are the essential details that we need to collect for this particular form. Now that we have done with this, I'll hit done here. And this is actually whatever we have done is the edit mode of this application. Now we're gonna see check this app in a live mode. So I click access this application, which would take me to the live mode of this application. So this is the live mode of this application. Here you can see all details form. Actually, this is a record which has been created for our show details form. So whenever you give a detail input to this form, a record will be automatically created for you. So I'll just give a input and then show you how our record also looks. So now I've given all the details, so I'm gonna hit show here. So I'll just go and check the records. Now you can see a record has been automatically created once you given the feed for the particular form. So now that we have done with the first form.
Now that we have completed the first feature, our next step is to create another form to book a seat.
So we are here to create a next form for this application. This form is called as book your seat. You're going to send this application to your customers and ask them to book a seat for your drama. So the logic is like this. You're going to show them the show details, all other required information to the customer, and customer is going to book his total number of seats that he wants to visit this drama. So I'm going to click this plus symbol and create a new form. I'm going to name this form as book your seat. In this form, I'm going to use a special field called lookup field, which will be used to fetch the records from the earlier show details form. So I'm going to use this. Here I'm going to fetch records from the show details form. I need the show theme, because if my customer is going to click this show theme, he needs to know all other details available about this particular show. So lookup field will fetch records from the previous form. Here you can also use this lookup field to fetch records from even different applications also. That is the specialty of this particular lookup field. Add a note field here. When my customer clicks this show theme option, he needs to know the informations available for that particular show. So I'm gonna use this field and write a workflow later. So next I'm going to use a number field where my customer needs to enter the total number of seats that is required for him. So I'm going to write this as enter the number of seats. Next, I'm again going to add a add note field, because if my customer enters the seats required, which is see total number of seats are not available. So I'm going to use the add note field. I'm going to write a workflow for this later. I guess we have done with the show theme and total number of seats required. Now it's time to collect the information about the particular customer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a sub form here, a form inside a form. So this is also a form which is available inside a form. So it's called a sub form. You can rename this as booking details. And I'm going to add fields like name, phone number, the basic details of my customer. This should do to collect my customer details. Next, I'm going to add a confirmation field, because I need to confirm with my customer whether he is ready to book the particular number of seats that he has given to us. So that's it. This is the form that we have created for book your seats, where your customer can come and book a particular number of seats that he requests for the particular show. So I hit done. Now we can access this application in the live mode. So as I told you, this is the lookup field where if you click this, see drama which we gave in the details form that is available here. Next, if at all you click this here, the particular show's detail has to be displayed here, which is not available as of now, but we will write a workflow for that and make available. And next, the person has to give the total number of seats that is required for him. As I told, this is the subform. So I just have to click add a new and give the details, email, phone number, just confirm it and submit the form. A record will be automatically created for you. So guys, just pause this video and check how this form works. Now that we have completed the book your seat form, as I told you, I'm going to perform certain workflows to display the information about the particular show theme and also the total number of seats available for the particular show. So first I'm going to hide these two fields, like you can see add your note field. So first I'm going to hide these two fields. So I click workflow, create a workflow. So I'm going to click book your seat. I'm going to name this field as hide. So I'm going to click fill new action, hide fields. I want to hide field like plane 1 and plane 2. So that's it. You can hit done and now you will not be able to see those two add note fields here. I'll just show you the form in the live mode. See, those two files are hidden here. So the next thing that I'm going to do here is when my customer clicks the show theme form, he has to get all the required information about that particular drama. So I'm going to write a new workflow for that. Now I'll choose a form from the book my seat area and I want this to be run on create or editor. I'll name this form as show details. Add a new action on user data input of show theme. So when my customer clicks the show theme option, immediately he has to get all the information about that particular drama. I'm going to write. So this is the deluge script workspace where you have to just drag and drop it over. It's just like the form creation. So I'm going to use the fridge records form here. What this does is, first I'll name it and then I'll explain you. So I'm going to use the variable details from the form. What exactly this line of code does is, this line gonna fetch records from the show details form. So ID is a unique value that has been created by the delete script. So this will go and search for the show theme in the show details form and exactly take all the records and display it over in this form. So next I'm going to write, this line of code is for to displaying all the particular details in that notepad which we added in the first field. The line of code here is input dot show details. So I'm bringing this field here and I'm going to display all the required information here. So this is the code where this code will display all the show name, then description, ticket price, venue, show date and time, total number of seats available for that particular number of seat. So this code is done. I'm going to hit update here and then go to the application and see how this code works. So in here, when I click the drama field, now you can see the show details information has been posted over here. So this workflow is working for us. Next, we're going to create a workflow where if a customer enters the particular number of seats required for him, then the system has to show him whether the tickets are available or not. I'm going to hit a new workflow. I'm going to name this workflow as total number of seats. So I want to do this workflow when a customer selects the total number of seats field. So the logic behind this form is, as I told you, whenever a customer enters the total number of seats required for him, the system has to cross check with the available number of seats and tell him whether he can book the seats for the particular number or not. So I'm going to use the field fetch records from the form show details, ID. So what this line of code does is, when a particular customer enters the show theme and the total number of seats required, then this has to go and cross verify with the earlier form, that is show details, and check the total number of seats available. So I'm going to use this if condition. So the total number of seats that is available for the particular show, if it is greater than or equal to the entire number of seats, then this condition should run. As you see, this is self-explanatory, but still I'll explain you again. The total number of seats entered by the particular customer is greater than or equal to the total number of seats available, then he cannot book the seat. But now lesser than or equal to the total number of seats that are available for the particular show, then he has to get a message like the seats are available. So I've written a code for that. Now I'm going to write a code for else condition. So as you see, if the total number of seats are more than the available number of seats, then he will get an alert message and the form will get automatically reloaded. So now that we are done with the form workflow, I'll click submit and then we'll check how this form works in the live mode. So we are in the live mode of this app. Let us check it. I give the theme drama. So the first workflow is working. Next, I want to enter the total number of seats that I want for this particular show. Say if I want 10. There is no message display. That means the total number of seats that I entered is less than the available number of seats. So that means I can go and book the seats. What if I give 60? Then see, sorry, the selected number of seats are not available. Select a different show. So this means that our second workflow is also working. Next, we're gonna write a third workflow where every time a customer buys particular number of seats, then that number should be subtracted from the available number of seats. So we're going to write a workflow for this. I'm going to create a new form, add new action on the user data input, enter the total number of seats available. So here I'm going to just reduce the count from the available number of seats. My variable seat count is equal to input dot. Next, I'm going to fetch the record from the previous form for total number of seats available. So I'll name this as show details, this variable. Next, the form is show details form. Here, when ID is equal to show team, this line of code will extract the details from the previous show details form when a person enters the show team. Now, what I want to do here is the particular show dot number of total number of seats, number of seats minus. So this particular workflow will reduce each number of seats from the available seats whenever a customer buys one. So I'll just hit save and check whether this workflow works. Now we'll check the workflow in the live mode of this application. I'll access this application, go to book your seat. So as you can see, I'll first display the details required. The available seats are 50. Now I'll enter 10 seats as my required. I'll just give the fill in the details. So I hit confirm your booking and submit the form. Done with the second workflow, we'll check the basic calculation. I already had 50 seats. I have taken 10 seats from that, which means the available seat should be 40 now. So when I click the drama show theme fee, see, you can see only 40 seats are available, which means our third workflow is also working.
Next, we're going to see our last feature, which is sending a notification mail to your customer who has booked his seat. The another option is we're going to see how to share this application in a public forum.
So the final feature of this app is we're going to send notification to the booked customers and also share this application online. So first I'm going to write a workflow for sending the notification. I hit workflow, add a new action. See, there is an option available here where you can send the notification. First, I want to get a success message on successful confirmation. So here I want the message to be tickets booked. I hit save. So I'll add a new action to send a mobile notification. So I'll just send SMS to default to the phone number that which we have got from the customers. So the message will be tickets. So the next action I'm gonna do here is I'm going to send a mail. So I'll use the notification send mail from the admin user to the email ID which we have collected from the customers. So the subject will be tickets booked, and you can add a message like hi, your tickets. You can even insert fields like the show name or theme or the total number of seats booked. You can do whatever you want. So I'll just give a sample of show name. So your tickets booked for the theme, show theme will be displayed here. So I'll just save. So that's it. We have done all the coding to send a notification for these people. Now you can just check by giving inputs for this and see whether this workflow is working or not. Now that we are done with the sending notifications, the next thing I'm going to do here is share this application. There are two methods to do that. Either you can send this application to a particular user and ask them to use this application. But in your case, if you are running a business, you can't find your user, so you have to publish this online. So what I'll do here is I'll just hit the settings option where you can see this publish. So I hit it. Now you can choose which form that you have to publish online. For me, I have to publish the book a seat form, so I'm just gonna hit this and publish. Here you will be getting the link. Either you can copy this link and post it in your website, or even embed this particular form in your website. So I just copy this and paste it in my social medias or sites, wherever I want to use this, I can use this. So this is how you have to share and publish your application. It's very easy.
Now that we have completed this app, let us have a quick demo.
Now I'm going to show a small demo for this application. So I go to the live mode of this app and enter all my details and show a quick demo. Now that I have entered my details for this, I'll hit show where my records will be seen here. So if you can go and see this, see, you can see the new show has been added to this. Now I will go and check in the book your seats form. So if you click the show theme, now you can see the different shows available for me. I hit this thriller and then immediately the details will be displayed here. Now if I want like 10 seats, there won't be any problem. But if I enter 30 seats, then there will be a problem saying that the seats is not available for you. So again, I have to reload this form with 10 seats. Then I'll enter the once I click confirm and hit submit, first a message will be displayed to my mail and also to my phone number. So guys, that's it for the quick demo. You can try this and check whether you're getting the notification, whether you're able to find the price, whether you are able to, you can also add gateways to the, that is the another option available given by the Zoho creator, so that you can get directly payment from your customers once they book this seats.
Our developers have created a seat booking app and that is stored in the app deck. Let us go and take a look at it and see what are the different features and the additional features that our developers has given to you.
So for the app gallery, I have hit this place and now I'm going to install this particular seat bookings app which is available in this app deck, and I'll show you what are the other features that are available in this app. So this is the seat booking app available in our app deck. So you can just explore various options available for you. You can see that it's more better and the UI looks very prominent here. You can just go check the options. You can just pick your seat and you can just give all the details here. You can see all the available bookings. So that's it guys. I guess you felt more easier to create an app with Zoho Creator. And if at all you have any doubts, if at all you want to explore any other features, you can just go and explore into this. So that's it. If you like this video, hit like and share with your friends and
hit the subscribe button now, and we will make you master in building the custom apps. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching this video, and wait till the next video comes out.